In this video, I will explain how to perform active high pass filter using op-amp IC741. This is the circuit of active high pass filter. It consists of op-amp IC741. Here we have given plus VCC and minus VCC. Plus VCC is given to pin number 7 and minus to pin number 4. And at pin number 3, we have connected a capacitor C which is of 0.1 microfarad and resistor R which is of 1 kilo ohm. Both this capacitor and resistor forms the high pass filter. And the resistor R1 and RF and this op-amp IC, this act as non-inverting amplifier. Together, this high pass filter and this amplifier forms the active high pass filter. Now we will calculate its cutoff frequency using this formula. The cutoff frequency formula is given as 1 divided by 2 pi RC. Once we substitute this value, that turns out to be f is equal to 1.59 kHz. That means till 1.59 kHz we don't get any signal, as we can observe here in graph. After 1.59 kHz we will get the output voltage. This is the graph of the high pass filter. For the sake of convenience, we have taken or noted down some readings. In this tabular column, we can observe that this is applied frequency. We are applying this frequency from function generator. And this is output voltage. We are observing this output voltage at pin number 6 in CRO. At same time, we are calculating the gain, which is V0 divided by Vin. Here at input voltage, we have given as 1 volt and we are observing the output. In this tabular column, we can observe that as we increase the frequency, the output voltage also increases. Somewhere nearly cutoff frequency, the output voltage is increased to 0.4 volt or sometime more than 1 volt. And we have to calculate the gain, and we should calculate gain in dB. Then we have to draw the graph. Once we draw the graph, and once we mark minus 3 dB on the graph, and that line is intersected on the graph, that gives the cutoff frequency. In this way, we conduct active high pass filter. Let's do this practically. Here on this breadboard, we have connected a op-amp and R and C. This together act as high pass filter, and R1, RF and this op-amp act as a non-inverting amplifier. These together act as active high pass filter. At input, we have given the signal from function generator. We have set its voltage as 1 volt and we are changing its frequency. At same time, as and when we vary the frequency, we measure its amplitude. The input is connected to channel 1 of the CRO. The output of the filter is connected to the channel 2 of the CRO. Now let's vary the frequency and observe the output. Here I have set the frequency as 500 Hz. Let's set it to 500 Hz. Once I set it to 500 Hz, here we can observe that the input voltage is 1 volt, but whereas the output voltage is less than 1 volt. It is almost 0.6 volt. Now let's change the frequency from 500 Hz to 1 kHz. I will change the frequency. Now let's change the frequency from 500 Hz to 1 kHz. Set it to 1 kHz. When I apply this as a 1 kHz from function generator, here we can observe that in CRO, the voltage, output voltage is increased from 0.6 to it is almost 0.8 volt. Now, instead of 1 kHz, I will make it to 2 kHz. When I make when I made this value as a 2 kHz, then output also increased from 0.8 to 1.2. Now I will change from 1 to 5 kHz. Let's change its range, set it to 5 kHz. Here we can observe that as we increase the frequency after cutoff frequency, the voltage is also increased. At cutoff frequency, at frequency of 5 kHz, we are getting the output voltage as 1.6 volt. Now I will change to 10 kHz. Here and we observe that the output is constant. That means after cutoff frequency, the output is almost constant. Near to the cutoff frequency, the output voltage goes on increasing. In this way, we conduct the active high pass filter using op-amp 741.